The ClonaCell product line provides an efficient method for selecting and cloning hybridomas after fusion between immune splenocytes and myeloma cells. The semi-solid media allows single cells to grow into discrete colonies that can be isolated easily. This ensures a high probability of monoclonality, thereby minimizing the need for subcloning. Due to the fact that discrete clonal colonies are formed and both slow and fast-growing colonies are isolated, the probability of obtaining rare, high-quality, and high-yielding clones is also increased. The ClonaCell HY kit includes all components for the development of monoclonal antibodies: medium A for pre-fusion culture, medium B for fusion, medium C for recovery, medium D for selection and cloning, medium E for post-selection and cloning growth, polyethylene glycol or PEG for the fusion step. The detailed procedure can be found in the ClonaCell HY Hybridoma Cloning Kit Technical Manual. Steps covered in this video include preparation of myeloma cells, preparation of splenocytes, fusion, selection and cloning, and harvesting. Myeloma cells. To prepare myeloma cells, thaw the parental myeloma cells and culture in medium A for at least 1 week prior to fusion. There must be at least 20 million parental myeloma cells available for fusion. Harvest parental myeloma cells by transferring to a tube and centrifuging. Wash 3 times with medium B. Remove the supernatant by pipette and resuspend the pellet in 25 mL of medium B. Perform a viable cell count. The viability should be greater than 95%. Calculate the volume required for 20 million viable cells. Splenocytes. To prepare splenocytes, disaggregate the spleen into a single cell suspension. To disaggregate the spleen, place a mesh screen on top of a 50 mm conical tube. Pre-wet the screen with 5 mL of medium B and place the spleen on the mesh. Grind the spleen using the plunger of a 3 mm syringe. Rinse the screen to flush all the splenocytes through the mesh and into the conical tube. Wash splenocytes 3 times in medium B. Remove the supernatant by pipette instead of pouring it off as the cell pellet is fairly loose. Resuspend in 25 mL of medium B. Perform a nucleated cell count. Calculate the volume required for 100 million cells. Washing both myeloma cells and splenocytes with serum-free medium B is very important. If serum is not removed, PEG will not fuse the cell membranes and the fusion frequency will drop drastically. Myeloma and spleen preparation can be done at the same time to ensure that one cell type is not sitting for an extended period of time. Fusion. PEG and media A, B, and C will be required for fusion. Pre-warm them at 37 degrees Celsius. Ensure that a 37 degrees Celsius water bath is ready for the fusion steps. Add 20 million parental myeloma cells and 100 million viable splenocytes to a 50 mL tube. Centrifuge and aspirate the supernatant. It is important to completely remove the supernatant to avoid diluting the PEG that will be added. Tap the bottom of the tube to disrupt the cell pellet. Add 1 mL of PEG dropwise using a 1 mL serological pipette. The PEG should be added over the course of 1 minute with no stirring. After addition of PEG, stir with the pipette tip for 1 minute. Add 4 mL of medium B over 4 minutes while continuously stirring. Slowly add an additional 10 mL of medium B. Incubate for 15 minutes in a 37 degrees Celsius water bath. Slowly add 30 mL of medium A and centrifuge. Discard the supernatant and wash with medium A to ensure that all the PEG is removed. Slowly resuspend the pellet in medium C. Transfer to a T75 flask containing medium C. Incubate for 16 to 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius with 5% CO2. Selection and cloning. Selection and cloning in semi-solid medium D are done after overnight incubation following infusion. Prepare medium D by thawing in the fridge overnight. It will be required on the day after fusion. Shake vigorously and let sit at room temperature for at least 15 minutes to warm up and allow the bubbles to rise to the top. Transfer the fused cells from the T75 flask to a tube. Centrifuge. Remove the supernatant and resuspend in 10 mL of medium C. Do not exceed a volume of 10 mL at this step. Using too much or too little liquid medium will affect the viscosity of the semi-solid medium D and the growth of the colonies. Transfer the 10 mL of cells and medium C into the 90 mL bottle of medium D. Mix thoroughly and let the bottle stand for approximately 15 minutes so the bubbles rise to the top. Aseptically plate 9.5 mL of cells in medium D into 100 mm dishes. We recommend the use of a syringe and blunt end needle. Do not use a serological pipette to avoid medium and cell loss due to sticking of the viscous medium to the inside of the pipette. Tilt and rotate each dish to ensure that medium is evenly distributed. Put the 100 mm dishes inside a larger dish and add another dish containing sterile water with no lid to prevent dehydration of the cultures, then cover the dish. Incubate the plates for 10 to 14 days at 37 degrees Celsius and 5% CO2. Harvesting. Because medium D is semi-solid, each single hybridoma cell that has survived the hat selection has grown into a discrete colony that can be isolated separately. Prepare 96 well plates by adding 200 microliters of medium E to each well. Inspect the 100 mm dishes for colonies visible to the naked eye. Be careful not to move the plates abruptly to avoid disrupting or smearing the colonies, which tend to be very loose. Set a pipette to 10 microliters. Using a sterile pipette tip, aspirate each colony. Transfer it to a well of a 96 well plate. Use a new pipette tip for each colony. Pipette the contents of the wells several times to resuspend the colonies. A single cell suspension is not required, but gently dispersing the colony will promote cell proliferation. Colonies of different sizes should be selected. Slower growing clones are often very good at producing antibodies. Grow cells for approximately 4 days and screen for specific antibodies using appropriate screening assays. ClonaCell is also available for transfected CHO cells and other cell lines. Visit stemcell.com for more information about ClonaCell.